everybody. How's it going tonight? How y'all feeling?
Woo!
I'm really excited about this one tonight. This is the first five mics that has featured piano. During the sound check, it was just a really cool experience to hear, you know, the dynamics compared to a piano and or synth sounds or whatever, to what normally would happen with acoustic instruments. So I'm, again, just really excited about this one. Just a little bit of insight on what this show is about. There are some wonderful, talented musicians that are here to play these songs that they've written and put a lot of energy and thoughts and love and their soul into. And they're here to share it with you guys. And part of this concept is that there's kind of no barrier between the stage and you guys here sitting on the floor. We really want you to feel comfortable, engaging. If you have questions or ideas about anything you hear, please feel free and reach out. Like, this listening and experience and this exchange is the reason that we're here. So I encourage you guys to engage. And if you don't have anything to say, that's great. You can just observe. That being said, there was a particular five mics last season that I played that we had Steve West play on. And one thing for me that kind of becomes challenging is when I'm up there playing and I have an instrument, taking the role of a performer as a moderator as well is kind of difficult. I feel better behind an instrument. I wish I had a guitar in my hand. I saw what Steve did, like, and he was able to do really actually both and was able to kind of engage the audience more than I had been able to the first couple of times. And so we kind of hung out and had a couple beers and like, Steve, you want to like come hang out and like be this kind of voice and kind of this way to make everyone else feel more comfortable. So Mr. Steve West is with us tonight. And, you know, he may or may not break some ice. If he doesn't, then by all means, any of you guys are more than welcome.
That's just a long way of saying I have a great big mouth and I don't mind asking questions out loud. But the whole thing is about people just asking whatever comes on your mind, from the micro to the macro, like why do you do what you do, anything that comes to your mind. And so that broken down barrier sometimes makes for really fertile conversation. And we've found from that point forward that that's sort of become sort of a thing that we do here for five mics. So by all means, don't be shy.
Yeah. And you guys as well, don't be shy either.
I'm not shy.
So backstage, before we came out, we drew straws to see who would play first. And Mr. Jake McLaughlin, he drew the short straw. So
as JC just said, my name is Jacob McLaughlin. This song is called Zero Gravity. I wrote it back in 2010.
Planets falling out of orbit.
natural fear of going blind, so I often will like practice with my eyes closed. You seem to have a really good handle on that.
Thank you.
I love the piano.
My name is Daryl McElveen. I'm gonna play Let It Go, the song Let It Go, about, I'm gonna play another song that I later, that was in the same period of time. I watch a lot of politics. I like it. I'm involved in Vermont Work Center here. And, I was sitting on a lazy boy with my keyboard watching this, and I was upsetting myself, and I had already been saying Let It Go or whatever. And I love country music. I love like standards, American standard music. And the piano is like great for that. And so this was like most of the songs, like they it's not up to me. Like it's like they won't leave, and I have to play them. So there's like a thing with like the lyrics that I really liked, but we'll give you.
control, no doubt. Some people like to give you bad news. I think we think I'm way too much. And I think a hug could clean stuff up.
Taunting, like a clock is such an asshole. And so this song is about that. Clock counts it up, such an asshole, just taunting me. You're an idiot, talk, you're the worst. Each conceivable universe plays on a loop in my head. When I'm honest to God, just trying to go to bed. Tick tock, tick tock. Together.
Thank you. Jacob again. This song is called Winter Falling. I picked it to play tonight because I thought it was kind of fitting for the time period.
Everything feels right.
well done.
Thank you, thank you. That was something that I tried to work on doing, excuse me, when I was writing the song, is to try to paint a picture with the piano and the notes that I'm throwing out there.
This is not just a random plug for like me and him, if that, he and I incubated exactly how I always wanted to incubate with an artist, and that's quick plug, like, Alison and I actually play in a band together with keyboards, both of us are like super controlled, like never thought we'd be in a band together. But so what happened with James, he's looking at graphic at the time. It's exactly how I think my favorite bands got better. We just wanted to play all the time and recorded all the time and listen to what we did. And so this song came out one of the nights. James didn't even remember the words. James is possibly the best songwriter I've ever played with. In terms of what we're talking about, in terms of like, what's why I love about songs in general, the play in first person, third person, and irony, James is, but also being like real and not having too many words. James is just awesome. So we recorded the song. I think I had the chords or whatever, and just for this I added a
bridge.
Oh, because forever I was playing it was just and this is the only song, honestly. So Alison changed my songwriting in terms of my lyrics are whimsical and gentle. So I want
no whimsy.
No whimsy. And then she made sure. So this song is about a great day in Vermont.
Just dirty dishes.
creepy outside until we find a way in before we all go home. The night ain't over. We just dirty in dishes until we all go home. Not enough. The night ain't over.
James.
Perhaps one.